Hi everyone, this time I will show you how to crochet touch slippers. For this tutorial you will need some yarn, a hook and some markers. I'm using here Caprice Big by Relana and an 8mm hook. First you should know the length and the width of your slipper. I have here an example, so if your length it's 22 centimeters and your width 10 centimeters, then our starting chain should be 12. Okay, so, and you can do this for every foot, just only the lengths you need. And first we have to create a slip knot. For this, create a circle and put the long strand under the circle and put the yarn through. We have a loop. Insert your hook here and then tighten. Now we have to chain our stitches until we have a length of 12 centimeters, like here. And to chain stitches, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. And over and pull through and continue doing this until you have your length, your desired length. And then you can have a look if it's long enough. So you can use whatever you like, what you have at home. Yeah, actually this one is too long. Okay. Yeah, I think it's okay. Should be enough. And then we will crochet backwards. So this chain backwards, and we will start with an increase. Insert your hook into the second stitch from hook, pull up a loop, you have two loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through two. This creates a single crochet, but we want to increase, so we have to crochet one more single crochet into the same stitch. So we insert the hook into the same stitch, pull up a loop, we have again two loops on our hook, yarn over, and pull through two. Pull through two, yeah, that's right. So we have here an increase, and then we continue crocheting every stitch, a single crochet in every stitch. Until the end of the row, and we will increase into the last stitch. We will have an increase in the last stitch. But before we will increase, we will take a marker and insert it here. You can also use a different color. So a different yarn. So maybe you use a white one and you can insert it here. So whatever you have, you can use it for working. So now we will increase into the last stitch here, but we will increase not with two single crochet but with three. So you have to crochet three single crochets into this loop. So the first one, second into the same stitch, and the third. Okay, now we are working back this chain backwards, also single crochet in each stitch, and we will increase into the last stitch. And don't forget to weave in this end, so we will put it on our hook and it will disappear, so we don't have to sewing the ends later, or to sewing this end. Yeah, and it will, this short one is quite here, so you can hide it like this. So now we have only one stitch left, and now I will insert a new marker, or set a new marker also here. And then we'll have an increase two stitches into this stitch here. One single crochet and the second single crochet into the same stitch. Then we will have an increase into the next stitch. One single crochet and the second into the same. Okay. And also an increase into the third stitch. Okay. Then we continue crocheting single crochets until our marker. And now we have to move the marker from this stitch to here to know where to increase in the next round. And we will increase the next three stitches also here. So two single crochets in each of the next three. The first one, two single crochets here. Two single crochets into the second stitch and two single crochets into the third stitch, and then continue with single crochet until the end of the round, or until you reach the next marker. Okay, then we have to move the marker again. And now we have a different type of increasing. So we will first crochet one single crochet, then increase, one single crochet, then increase, one single crochet, and then increase. So one single crochet. Increase into the second stitch. One single crochet. Increase two single crochets into the next stitch. One single crochet. And an increase. And I'm using the back loop all the time. So, now this side is done. We're crocheting single crochets until the end of the, no, until the next marker. Till the next marker. Then we will move this one from here to here. And then again, single crochet, increase, single crochet, increase, single crochet, increase. Okay, a single crochet. Then an increase. Two single crochets into the same stitch, and I need some yarn. Okay, we had an increase, the next will be a single crochet. Then an increase again. Single crochet. And an increase. Okay. So, yeah. And then single crochets until the end of the round or until the end, the next marker. And at this point, you can have a look if it's big enough for you or not. And if it is, we can start doing the border and then the strap. And if it's not big enough, you will increase the next rounding or the next half circle here. You will work two single crochets, one increase, two single crochets, one increase, two single crochets, one increase. Here also the same. And then the next round would be three single crochets, increase, three single crochets, increase, and three single crochets, increase. And also here, and if you have more rounds, so every round you will do more single crochets between the increases. And now this one is okay, so it's big enough for me, and I will put a marker on the opposite side here to know when it is enough. So you will see why. This one we don't need anymore. So actually we need only two. Yeah, but I have enough of them. Okay, so now we have to chain one and to turn our work. And now we will work also the back loop. Single crochet through the back loop. So this is really important that you don't use these loops. You should use this one here. This is really important. And not both, only the one. And then continue crocheting single crochets here. Actually, I don't know, do you call this single crochet if it's plural or crochets? I don't know how to pronounce this. Okay, sorry, but I'm not English. This is only my school English I'm talking here. No, but I think it's quite good to understand, I hope. Yeah, and we work this without increasing. So forget all about increasing. If your slipper is big enough, we will crochet only single crochet all around here until the next marker. Yeah, this time I try to cut less to show you the whole crochet process. Maybe you can crochet along with me and something different. Maybe it's better for you to understand, to see it. Okay, so now we reached our second marker. This is the border or the edging here, and now we will work the strap for this chain one. Turn your work, and now you can use your loops which you like. It doesn't matter if you use both or only one, whatever, you can use whatever you like. And then you continue crocheting single crochets until your strap is long enough. So you can have a look if this length is okay for your strap or if you want to have more stitches. I think this is okay. So if it's long enough, then chain one and turn your work, and then continue working single crochets. Don't forget to insert hook always into the second stitch. So if you turn your work, you insert your hook always into the second stitch. Otherwise it looks a little bit funny. Yeah, and then you continue working in rows, and this will create your length. And I wanted to show you why I wanted to crochet this edging through the back loop, so you see you will get a really nice corner through this, so the fabric shapes itself. You don't have to do anything more. Yep. And now I wanted to turn. Yeah. I wanted to turn, I think, like this, was it? Yeah. you want, you can also turn your work first and then chain one. So it's up to you what you prefer. And the last two or three rows will be a little bit different. We have to decrease then. I don't know if it's, I think I will do one more row and then decrease. So we will get a nice shape, a round shape for our strap then at the end. So, mine is like this. It's some space left. And now we won't crochet a chain stitch at the end of the row. And we will turn our work like this. And also enter the hook into the second stitch. And this will create a decrease. You will see it after some rows. So once again you turn your work and you don't chain one and you insert your hook into the second stitch. And this will give you a different shape. So you see here, it's getting thinner. And then we should have a look if it's already big enough. Or maybe one more. More row. And the last stitch will be a slip stitch. So insert your hook into the last stitch and then put the yarn through all the loops on your hook. So this will be a slip stitch and then cut the yarn. And pull it through the last loop like this. So now you need a different color. I will take a white one. So if you have your new color, we will open our slipper here and search this corner. And then insert our hook through here. And pull through the white yarn and then create a slip knot, tie the yarn here and then insert your hook through the next stitch, pull up a loop and chain one. Then continue crocheting single crochets. We will take this one that we don't have to sew it afterwards. And here you have to search for stitches cause we don't have stitches here. And you take, I don't know, something what you think is right. So you should have a feeling how big a stitch is. And then you will see where to go with your hook through. And And you can also do some stitches and then have a look at your work. And then you see if it's too tight, too many stitches or too less. And then, yeah, you can also pull out the hook and then open your stitches and yeah, and you can redo it if it's not good for you, if you don't like it. So here you have some stitches, you can use them. Yeah, and you continue doing this all across here until you reach this corner. So if you're done with your edging, at this point you can finish off your work and cut the yarn, make sure it's long enough that you can sew it at this point directly here. Use a wool needle for sewing and you can sew the strap like this here, and then you will be done. And if you want to have also an edging here, I will show you how to continue. So, and the last stitch will be a slip stitch, and then cut your yarn and pull it through the last stitch. Don't forget to sew in the ends here, and then you will need a new strand of yarn to sew the strap onto here. And don't forget to cut these ends. Otherwise, it looks a little bit silly. Yeah, and that's it. That will be your slipper. I think a great gift for someone and for every time of the year. So I hope you like my tutorial. If you do, remember to rate it thumbs up. Bye-bye.